Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today's news headlines are: Lord Indra could postpone Brahmos-A launch from Sukhoi 30, report. Brahmos Aerospace developed Brahmos-A supersonic cruise missile, which was scheduled to be fired from a Sukhoi 30 MKI towards a decommissioned naval ship by end of this month, currently waits for approvals from the Lord Indra, god of lightning, thunder, storms, rains, since the news coming from the test site is not so positive. Monitoring team at the test site in the Bay of Bengal is witnessing severe bad weather condition in the area, which could postpone already delayed first debut flight test of fully loaded Brahmos-A cruise missile from a Sukhoi 30 MKI. In series of test planned for Brahmos-A, the first test will be to take down a target in the middle of the ocean. For that, a decommissioned warships will be towed and will be placed in selected path, and to collect enough trial data, both ocean and environment needs to be calm for few days for carrying out missile test in the region. In the second stage, Brahmos Aerospace plans to then move on to air-to-land flight trials once Brahmos-A clears ASHM trials. If bad weather persists, then trials will have to be postponed for next month or later if conditions don't improve. Brahmos Aerospace will be in touch with ISRO and other weather monitoring agencies to look for ideal next launch window if the current month-end launch window is missed. ThyssenKrupp Marine ready for complete submarine tech transfer to India. German conglomerate ThyssenKrupp Marine Systems is banking on its vast experience in design and construction of submarines and the fact that it has delivered subs for coastal and blue water deployment to the navies of 19 countries, to help deliver India's next-generation submarines, the P-75I. The Indian Navy had recently flagged off the next stage of P-75I, by issuing Request for Information, RFI, to foreign original equipment manufacturers, OEMs. Even as the strategic partnership policy is set to unlock submarine building in the country, ThyssenKrupp is in talks with private Indian shipyards for Thai UPS, and is keen to be the foreign OEM of choice for the P-75I program. The German submarine specialist had recently landed a contract to modernize two Indian Navy Type 209/1500 submarines. Lauding the massive technological capability available at Indian shipyards, Gernad Sadi, managing director, ThyssenKrupp Marine Systems India, spoke to Businessline about how the P-75I contract would be an important milestone for the company, and how his team is looking forward to integrate any weapon system the Indian Navy may opt for. CAG slams Indian Navy for delay in anti-submarine warfare corvettes projects. The Controller and Auditor General has come down hard on the Indian Navy for causing inordinate delay in construction of four anti-submarine warfare corvettes. In a report tabled in Parliament, the federal auditor said two of the four warships were delivered to the Navy were not fitted with required weapons and sensor systems, due to which they could not perform to full potential as envisaged. The CAG was severely critical of the Navy's Directorate of Naval Design, DND, for delay in finalizing the design of the corvettes, saying approved designs were amended 24 times. The Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers Limited, GRSE, a defense public sector undertaking, DPSU, was issued letter of intent for the project in 2003, but major modifications in design of the ships continued till 2008. The first corvette was delivered to the Navy in July 2014 and second one in November 2015. According to the contract for the project, the third corvette should have been delivered in July 2014 and fourth in April 2015. Against the 18 weapons and sensors to be installed on ASW corvettes, audit observed that the two ASW corvettes delivered were not fitted with X weapon and sensor systems. Thus, ASW corvettes could not perform to its full potential as envisaged, the CAG said. Bharat Dynamics to develop data field loaders for rocket, missile systems. Bharat Dynamics Ltd., BDL, plans to design and develop an advanced data field loader system that can beef up weapon systems. The project would be taken up by the Defence Public Sector Unit as part of its efforts to improve self-reliance in the current financial year. The data field loader, DFL, helps in uploading and downloading mission and navigation data for rockets and missiles. Broadly, it can help in planning, execution, and maintenance of various systems on board and improve overall efficiencies. Pinaka Aerospace Solutions Private Ltd. has developed a DFL. Pinaka is a multi-barrel rocket developed by the Defence Research and Development Organisation for the Indian Army. It has the capability to launch rockets and target enemy targets up to 70 kilometers away. Fake Chinese spares for India-made Dhanush Bofors guns, alleges CBI complaint. Chinese parts camouflaged as made in Germany ones allegedly found their way to the production line of Indian-made Bofors artillery guns called Dhanush used by the army, prompting the CBI to file a case against a Delhi-based company. Besides SID Sales Syndicate, the CBI also registered a case against unidentified officials of the Guns Carriage Factory, GCF, Jabalpur, under criminal conspiracy, cheating and forgery for supplying fake and cheap China-made spares passing off as made in Germany for Dhanush guns, the FIR alleged. Dhanush is the indigenist version of the Bofors artillery guns which performed exceedingly well during the Kargil conflict in 1999. The CBI alleged that the supplier entered into criminal conspiracy with the unidentified GCF officials to supply duplicate spare parts, bearings, used in the manufacture of Dhanush guns. In furtherance of the said criminal conspiracy, unknown officials of GCF accepted the Chinese manufactured wire race roller bearings supplied by SID Sales Syndicate which were embossed as CRB made in Germany, the CBI said in the FIR. The agency said production and performance of the Dhanush gun is extremely crucial for India's defense preparedness and wire race roller bearing is its vital component. Russia shows off Orion-E UAV which will rival American Predator. Russian defense company Kronstadt Technologies is showing in public for the first time at MAX 2017 its latest medium altitude, long endurance, MALE, Orion-E Unmanned Air System, UAS. According to the company, the Orion-E is the first UAS in Russia with long-range drones, corresponding to the international classification of the MALE class. The new Russian drone looks like a US MQ-1 Predator developed by General Atomics and AVIC Swing Long Block 1. According to the promo video of Orion-E, the aircraft features a slender, 8m long fuselage, high aspect ratio wings, and a V-tail. The drone has 16m wingspan in flight. The aircraft is intended to carry a payload of 60 kilograms, but can lift a maximum load of 200 kilograms, according to a production information card. Kronstadt will work with Rosonburn Export to market the Orion-E abroad, with a specific interest in sales to Southeast Asia, Latin America, and Africa.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.